Okay, so what time is it?
It is 7:08.
It is 7:08, yeah. And we are in the hospital. Today is March 21st. Yeah. It is Sunday evening, and this is the night that we will be induced. So I have an IV in me, and there's Ava's little bed that she's going to be in. Those are the monitors, and here's Daniel about to eat. Something that sadly I can't do. I am starving. So they gave me a pill called Cervadil. It's supposed to help soften my cervix because if you want, because it might get cold. Yeah, so they gave me a pill called Cervadil. It's gonna help soften my cervix. Because she checked my cervix, I'm still not dilated and it's hard. So this is gonna help soften my cervix. So they wanna do like a 3-step process. So first is the pill, and then they're gonna check me again at midnight. So right now it's 8:25. They're gonna check me again at midnight. If I'm about 1 to 2 centimeters dilated, they're gonna inflate like this balloon in my cervix to help like stretch it out, and then they're gonna give me Pitocin, which is going to jumpstart the contractions. How do you feel, Papa Bear?
This feels tight. Is this tight?
No.
It's kind of tight, no?
I'm not talking about the shirt. I'm asking you, how do you feel?
Oh, I feel good. Cause I'm gonna be a dad soon. I'm already a dad. So I'm gonna be a dad again. I'm happy. Ava's gonna come out, and you know, she's gonna be a big baby. No? Oh.
Please help. We'll check back around 12, and I'll let you guys know if we have some dilation going on.
Hey guys, update. So my wife took the second doses that they actually came over to give her. As you can see, she's right in the bed. Yeah. And the next one is supposed to be at 4 a.m. So we're trying to get some rest. I have the dad couch. I'm trying it out. It's painful. As you can see, look at my eyes. I'm dying. Help me. I need some help. Baby, how you doing? Are you okay?
I'm crampy. But I'm okay. Not bad.
Okay. Ava has been moving, but it seems like she's sleeping right now. But until the next update. Update, it is 1:06. So they get on sleep. How are you?
Tired.
We're both tired, trying to adapt. We're both inside the room. I just gave her the thing for her lashes. Yay. So, I had to show you something. The nurse did something really, really nice. They gave us a little hat for her to wear. Look at this. So cute. So, so cute. And this is actually where she's going to be at. So adorable. Ava, you 10-pound baby. Come out soon. Come out soon. How's your pain, baby?
So.
Okay. How is it sleeping like this for you?
Mm-hmm.
How is it adapting and being in the hospital?
It's not bad.
It's not bad?
Mm-hmm.
How are they treating you here? Good? Okay. You treating her good? They're treating me good? It's my favorite to come out. It's 1:00. Nope. Well, I'm suffering right now. Until the next update. Okay. The time is 3:43. Okay. It's 3:43. Can you see me? 3:43 right now. Alright. I had to stretch my back real quick. I don't know if you could see me or not. So
No, you can see
through the screen. Yeah. Currently, right now, I'm still trying to own this bed. You can't own the dad bed. Like, once you're in this bed, it destroys your back, like, completely. You feel like that you're on the corner 125th, in Manhattan, like, you know, that little corner right there, that's how you feel. You feel like one of them crackheads, like, you know, like, I don't want to feel like that, but I feel like that. Baby, how you feeling? You okay?
I'm tired. And I'm in pain.
Shout out to all the nurses in this place, because they really made sure my wife is very comfortable. They're very nice here. Jersey City Medical Center, definitely recommend if you're having your baby in Jersey to definitely go here. All right, I've been giving my wife water, been trying to stay up active, making sure she is okay. Oof. You hear the heartbeat. Make you wanna dance. Baby Ava is very, very active. She keeps moving. Like, she's always been active, but you could really tell that she's just always, like, moving all around. Like, she's ready. I don't know if she's ready to come out, but she's ready. She needs to come out. Ava, your dad loves you. Your mama loves you. It's about time we see your face. I want to know which one you look like more, so we know who's the stubborn one more. Either me or your mama. We gotta know. All right. To the next blog. Okay. Oh, it is 5:17 right now. Currently. A lot of contractions right now. A lot of contractions. They are from 45 seconds to a minute apart right now. She is really feeling it. Breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe out, breathe in, breathe out, breathe in, breathe out. Stay focused, okay? Stay focused, breathe in, breathe out. There you go, breathe in, doing amazing. Breathe out, breathe in.
I'm gonna just keep it on my face the whole time.
Yeah. No?
You have to update them.
Oh, like this?
Yeah. Yeah, really. So, yeah, you have to tell them about the balloon.
Oh, that's right. So, okay, so before they had to put the balloon, before they put a balloon in her, she was 1 centimeter dilated, but then they had to put the balloon procedure in her in order for her to be more dilated. So the doctor said that she is 2 centimeters dilated and the balloon is working well, which is good. So, right now, I'm making sure she concentrates on her breathing, make sure she's focused, and also, too, as well, I'm giving her a hand massage so it can get her off the pain. So, as you can see, hand massage, so she can really focus off the pain. I can tell she's really feeling it, and I know, she's strong. You're strong. You're strong. Okay? Yeah. Real strong. So the next update.
It is 6:55. They just broke my water. I am 3 centimeters dilated. I took an epidural because the pain was unbearable. Induced labor is more painful than regular labor because it's forcing your body to go into labor. So it was very bad. Like, it was excruciating pain. And I cried and I couldn't take it. So I did the epidural. I feel so much better. I feel numb. So that's why I look tired and crazy. But yeah. So they gave me Pitocin about 4. They gave me the lowest dosage, which is a 1 cc's. So that's gonna help progress my labor. And they inflated the balloon, and that was very painful. That made the contractions hurt 10 times more, and it was just unbearable. Now they have a catheter in me to empty out my bladder, because you can't move so much when you have an epidural. And I have a peanut ball in between my legs. Show it. You can't really see it, but it's helping.
You see like a little lump.
To open my cervix. So we're gonna try to get this thing going. I've been in labor for a good minute. Labor started around,
I would say literally like at maybe at 12.
Okay, like 12, I'm gonna say around 12, 1 o'clock. So it's been over 6 hours. So I don't know what time I'll be giving birth. I feel like it'll be sometime in the afternoon, because it's 7 o'clock right now. So hopefully the Pitocin and everything will speed it up. Now that they broke my water, that everything will speed up, and we'll see how it goes. I will give you guys an update in a couple of hours.
Seeing your water break was actually one of the best experiences I've ever seen, especially for you giving birth. And I hope you're gonna be feeling better. One of the, I would say, best experiences was actually seeing it, because when they actually put, when Dr. Gautreaux actually put her hand in, you know, in vocal water, you see everything. And I was like, oh, did her water break? She was like, yeah, like normal. I'm like, oh, okay, like, it's normal, right? I just didn't know it was like 1, 2, 3 easy like that. But she's wrestling, epidural is actually really kicking in, so. She should be feeling nothing at this point, which is good. So she's not feeling the contractions, because the contractions were very severe, that to a point that she really couldn't move. She was crying. It was very hard for her to get up, even to go pee. But I'm glad that she actually agreed to the epidural, so now everything is fine. So quick update. So we'll give you another one real time soon. Ending. Any last words, baby? No? You're just ready for Ava to come out. Okay. Love you, my mom.
Alright, the time is 8:50. Currently eating breakfast that they had given me. So they're giving me eggs with hash brown and have some fruit that I'm also eating. Cheerios with it looks like a banana muffin. I'm excited for it. With orange juice. Really, really good. I love the hospitality here. Baby currently sleeping. She's currently sleeping. So I am currently a little up. We slept for 50 minutes. So from the last, I would say, water broke. So they forced the water to break. So now she's just been resting. So everything is still the same. So yeah, I'm just eating breakfast now. Alright, this breakfast good. It's good. Okay, so she's resting. So I'm just gonna eat real quick. And so next update. Breathe in. Always make sure that I concentrate on her breathing, because definitely when she gets I definitely concentrate on her breathing, because definitely she's gonna need it, especially when she's going through severe contractions, and it's like a minute to 45 seconds apart. Breathe in, breathe out, breathe in, breathe out.
Breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe out. Focus on your breathing. Breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe out. And the only reason why it's so bad is because they had a force on the word to break. They had to force her to be dilated using the balloon method. So it's a lot of things that's going to cause even more severe pain. But I'm going to make sure I'll be by her side always and make sure that she's going to be okay through this. And I always got her back. So, husband duties. Okay, update is now commenced. So, baby is officially 6 centimeters. Oh, yeah. Whoa. It was very close for her to come out. She may come out by like at least 3. Or I'm hoping 2. What's I'm hoping for? What time you hoping for?
2.
2? Yeah, we're both hoping for 2. So she's right now 6 centimeters. She is feeling quite some pain, which is, yeah, quite some pain. So they gave her some painkillers, so hopefully that will kick in. Her epidermal is really close to being done and it's not being effective right now. Only reason why is because the contractions are getting more and more heavier. So right now she is being such a trooper. She keeps telling me she doesn't want no more kids, but I know we are gonna have some more. So she's really being a trooper though. Really is being a trooper.
Have more.
Yes, 2 more maybe. But she's really being a trooper.
Drugs. You could have them by yourself. How about you carry a baby?
I'll be a seahorse for the day. But so far right now, doing good. So until the next update. Spell family.
Family.
Yeah.
Family.
Family.
Huh? You said what?
You know Casey?
Who's that?
You know Casey.
The white kid? Oh.
Yeah, yeah, who's Casey?
He's my nephew.
Yeah. You know Clarissa?
Isn't that his mom?
Yeah. Who is Clarissa to you?
My friend.
No, not your friend.
Huh?
Clarissa is your sister.
I don't have sisters.
You do have a sister.
I don't have sisters.
You do have sister. Okay, so this is a huge update. Ava is here. A bundle of joy. She arrived.
14 hours of labor. Mm-hmm. She weighed 7 pounds, 3 ounces. I know. 20.58 inches long.
Mm-hmm.
And she was born at 3:53 p.m.
The labor was tough. It happened for 15 minutes, which was a feat. On how short it was, which I was amazed by that. And when she delivered Ava, we both cried. I was just so happy that she arrived. She was so happy that Ava arrived.
Okay.
I almost got smacked in the face multiple times. I'm making that note. And almost kicked in the face multiple times.
How
making that
would
note.
I kick you if my legs was
yeah,
numb.
You had your legs, like, cause you were pushing. You push your legs. You're like, ah, get the baby out of me. Like, you couldn't feel it, but then you felt it. I don't know, but. I'm glad she's here. I'm glad.
I know.
This new journey is starting now.
I know, Mama. She has so much hair.
Yeah, she got blessed.
Just take the hat off.
Got blessed
the
with my
head
jeans.
Is coming out. Just hold it.
Okay. But I am so excited that she's here. So happy that she's here.
Okay.
And it's just an amazing feat in itself. Yeah, it's just 2 hats they gave us. They gave us a blue bow and this hat right here. Shout out to Dr. Goltra, because she really did her thing. She really did her thing. Especially with our baby. Because she kept telling her, push, push, push. And she surely pushed. All right, gotta go to dad mode. Till the next time. You wanna say something, baby?
No more kids.
What?
Position it lower, baby.
Oh.
No more kids.
What?
That's it.
We're gonna have one more. Okay. Just one more.